In the previous video of our dimensional modeling series, we talked about fact and dimensional tables. We have learned how fact tables together with dimensional tables help us get meaningful information. I strongly suggest you to watch the previous video if you have not watched it already. In this session, we are going to learn about the different types of facts and fact tables. The first very common fact table type is transactional fact table. It captures the measurements of the transaction event at any point of time. For example, let's consider our fact sales table. In the case of the transactional fact table, it is going to have records for all ongoing sales or purchases made by the customer at any given point of time. So for every sale or purchase made, we will have a record in the table. If you look at the records in the transactional fact table, here each row represents the details of purchases made, and facts here are mostly additive in nature. Now, in order to understand what additive facts are, let's look closely at the units and quantity column. These measures can be summed up across any of the dimensions. If we do so, we can get the total amount or quantity as per the date range, store ID, or as per the customer. The result will always make sense, isn't it? So additive facts are measures that can be aggregated or summed across any of the dimensions associated with the fact table. Non-additive facts, on the other hand, are the facts that we can never add. Can we sum all discounts available on various products to calculate the total discounts offered by the store? Will it make sense? No. So far, we have seen examples of point-of-sale transactions, where each and every purchase is being captured in the transaction fact table. Now, like transaction tables, the business must maintain the inventory table to keep track of the product's availability. Or else, how would the business make sure that all products are available in store as per the demand, and how they are going to ensure that they are not running out of stock? Let's consider the sample inventory table. Here, each day, the inventory is updated as products are moved in and out of the stores. Now we can add the quantity on hand to get the total amount of inventory available in the stores for a given date. But we cannot add across all dates to get the total amount of inventory available. We can aggregate across the stores and products dimension, but not across the date dimension. The inventory level of a product on particular date is not equal to the sum of the inventory levels on previous dates. Facts like that, which can be added across some dimensions but not all, are called semi-additive facts. Now, what if we are not interested in each and every transaction detail that is happening, and rather we want to learn about the periodic information like weekly sales or monthly sales for our business analysis? So for this type of scenario, we use periodic fact table. Here, each record represents a group of transactions that happened over a period of time. Data is pulled out from the transactional fact table and aggregated on basis of the required period or date range. We talked about the sales order transaction table, where we keep all transaction details. We have also talked about their periodic aggregation. Now let's talk about the use case where we want to track the entire end-to-end details of the business process. For this purpose, we use accumulating snapshot fact table. Here, each record captures the entire life cycle of the business event, which has a definite lifetime. In our case, for an e-commerce sales event, it has a definite lifetime of 5 to 15 days, starting from order placement to the customer delivery. Each row represents the entire lifetime of the event and provides details like when the order was placed, when it was dispatched, dispatch location, delivery location, and when it was delivered. Each milestone of the workflow is captured and updated in the table. In this video, we have learned different types of facts. Now we understand the properties of different types of facts and we can easily identify them. We have also covered the types of fact tables and their use cases. In the next part of the series, I will talk about one other key concept in dimensional modeling, which is fact-less fact tables.